It's Rachel with Simple Slides. One of the best parts about PowerPoint is being able to create customized graphics for your presentation. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to merge shapes using the Union, Combine, Fragment, and Intersect features. Let's jump right in. Hello there. Today, we'll be talking about my most favorite tool in PowerPoint. This tool is absolutely fantastic in making graphic stuff for your presentations, or just some simple PowerPoint art that you can do without the need for Photoshop or other image editing software. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking about merge shapes. Merge shapes can be found when you select two or more shapes and then go to the Format tab and select Merge Shapes under the Text Box tool. Merge shapes is a very fascinating feature of PowerPoint since it allows us to create custom graphics that we can use for our presentations. And now, I want to show you exactly how amazing this tool is and how almost limitless the possibilities are that you can do with PowerPoint just because of this tool. First, let's talk about the number one option in merging shapes, which is union. Basically, union is used to merge two or more shapes as one. Simple as that. For example, I have prepared here two rectangular shapes, which I want to merge as one big rectangular shape. All I have to do is select both of them by pressing Ctrl plus left-clicking on both shapes, and then going to the Merge Shape box and selecting Union. As you can see, both shapes have merged into one. This tool is very useful if you want to make custom shapes using the readily available shapes in the Shapes box. For example, I want a custom shape that is a combination of a rectangle and a heart shape. All I have to do is intersect them to my liking. Select both shapes and then just click Union. Now I have this custom mosque-like shape, which I can use for my graphics. Next option we'll look into is Combine. We use Combine to merge shapes into one and to omit any parts that overlap. So again, we have two rectangular shapes here for our example. Let's say we want to combine them. First, let's overlap these two. Select them, go to Merge Shapes, and click Combine. As you can see, both shapes have merged into one again. However, the parts that overlapped have been removed. Again, you can use this option to make custom shapes. I don't really use this option often, but let me show you a cool trick you can do with Combine. First, get a text box and type in anything. For example, love. A little cheesy, I know. Next, bring out the heart shape to accompany our text and place it to your liking. Now for the magical part. Select your text along with the shape. Go to Merge Shapes, click Combine, and boom! You have this cool text design where the overlapping parts are actually empty. This would be cool for making logos, text design, etc. Now moving on. We have another option which I also rarely use, but is still a helpful tool, which is Fragment. Like the name suggests, we use Fragment to split the shapes into different pieces depending on how they are placed and or intersect. Kinda hard to explain with words. Let me just show you using our golden box voice here. So as usual, we kinda overlap the shapes however we want. Let's go for a little offset to the right. Select both shapes, go to Merge, click on Fragment, and there you have it. It's basically merged as one, but this time we have the option of fragmenting them into different pieces. So the overlapping part is a separate piece, and the two non-overlapping parts are also separate pieces of a big shape we just merged. Pretty cool. But not as cool as the next option, which is Intersect, one of my most favorite merge tools. So basically, we use Intersect to select only the overlapping parts of the shape while omitting the rest. Only the overlapping parts remains here. For example, we have these two again. Overlap them in the middle, select both of them, and click Merge. Intersect, and voila! Just the overlapping part remains. So, one interesting thing you can do using Intersect is you can crop out parts of the picture using certain shapes. Let's copy this. Paste it on our slide canvas. Resize a little. There, my favorite picture of beans. For example, I only want this part of the picture, and I want it to be circular. So what we do is insert a circular shape, put it over the image, select the image, then the shape, go to merge, click on intersect, and there you have it. Now I bet you're already thinking of more possibilities using this option. Like for example, I want a text that says beans to be filled with this image of beans. So we do the same process. Grab ourselves a text box that says beans. Select the image, select the text box, go to merge, and intersect. Bada bing, bada boom. We have beans in beans. That's very deep, actually. And now for the last option of merge shapes, and probably one of the more useful ones, subtract. We use subtract to omit the shape you selected second from the one you selected first. Let me show you. So for example, we have the usual suspects here. I will overlap them like this. Now I want to keep the parts below and remove the rectangular part. Just select first the shape you want to remain, and then the one you want to subtract. Go to merge, select subtract, and voila, you're left with this custom shape. Here's another example. What if you want the box, but with a heart inside that is empty? Well, we just insert those shapes here. Put the heart inside the square. Select on the square shape first, then the heart. Go to merge, then choose subtract. There you go, a box with an empty heart inside. We hope this was helpful. Subscribe to our channel for more PowerPoint tips.